Hey guys, how's it going? So it's summertime right now, and I bet some of you might have some travel plans around the corner. So this will be the best tech to take with you on your next vacation. So let's just get right into it. None of this is sponsored. All the products I'm going to talk about here, I either bought myself or they were sent to me for review. But I'll disclose all that as we get into it. So first, you're going to need a backpack. And I don't never really heard of this brand, but apparently they're fairly well known. This is Briggs & Riley. It's not a cheap bag. I think on Amazon, it goes anywhere between $200 and $300. But what I really like about it is incredibly well made and it is gigantic too. So if you are a psychopath like I am and you take your gigantic 18-inch gaming laptops with you whenever you travel, this actually fits it. It even fits the Titan 18, but I'm using the Razer Blade 18 now, and it actually fits in there perfectly. And on top of that, there's a whole bunch of pockets, and I don't know. It's just a really, really good backpack. The company didn't send this to me. I think my dad actually bought this for me, so thank you, Dad. I know a lot of my viewers on this channel are gamers and buy gaming laptops, and I would really recommend not buying those gamer-branded backpacks like the Razer backpacks, ROG backpacks, MSI backpacks, etc., because theft right now is rampant all around the world. Thieves are hanging out in like airports, train stations, museums, anywhere where there's expected to be a lot of tourists. And what they do is they target individuals and they'll steal their backpacks. And these gaming laptops are sometimes $4,000. And like, think about it, if you wanted to sell your $4,000 gaming laptop for $3,000, it'll be sold within a day. Same thing with camera equipment, etc. So I feel like when you use one of those branded backpacks, or if you just use an expensive backpack with a really well-known name, you're just drawing a lot of attention to yourself and it increases the chances of you getting targeted. So what I like about this is a very well-made, pretty much luxurious backpack, but it kind of just fits in. No one's going to really know that a $4,000 gaming laptop is in here or $3,000 worth of camera equipment, etc. So yeah, really like this backpack. Let's move on. So now, in terms of computers, I am really on this Microsoft Copilot Plus laptops. And right now I'm deciding between three of them. I feel like I'm going to keep one of them at some point, but man, Windows is really back in business right now with these Copilot Plus laptops. And just in terms of the overall performance and battery, the battery life itself, this Surface laptop, I don't know how long it's been lasting, but I haven't been able to kill this in one day's use. I'm leaning towards a Surface Pro 11 because of how versatile it is. I mean, especially if you spend the extra money and get this keyboard with the case. This keyboard works even when it's detached. So I can imagine if you're on a plane, so you could just have the Surface Pro on the tray and then just keep the keyboard on your lap. And I've been using this a lot where I could just have this further away and just be able to type away and just still be able to use this device. It's been wonderful. Probably one of the best devices I've used this year. I mean, if you do prefer a traditional laptop, the two that I am also considering is the Surface laptop. They're both really good devices, though. I think in terms of build quality and battery life, and in terms of just being the perfect size, this 15-inch might be the way to go. But if you care about display, this is one of the best OLED screens I've seen on a laptop. It's got an anti-glare coating on it, similar to that of the S24 Ultra. So if you can just see the difference right here, it makes a really big difference. And one good thing about this anti-glare coating on the Samsung Galaxy Book 4 Edge is it doesn't seem to destroy the visual performance the way most other matte displays do. So overall, all really good devices, but I just think in terms of versatility, I feel like you're getting both a tablet and a really good computer. And with this wireless keyboard set, I would say my vote for the computer that you might want to travel with would be the Surface Pro. If you're a MacBook user, then you know I'm not going to be able to change your mind on that, but that's okay. And speaking of Apple, the iPad is also a contender too. I just feel like, honestly, and I said this in my review of it, like, or my first look of it, I still just don't understand where this product fits. At the end of the day, this is essentially just iOS with some extra features on it. So, I mean, if you might want the simplicity of just having a gigantic iPhone on you, I mean, yeah, you could do some real work on this too. But And especially after these Copilot Plus PCs came out, like, you're getting a full operating system and a tablet experience, while this is just mostly just a tablet experience. But to each their own, all great products. This is the iPad Pro 13 M4 edition. By the time I configured this, it was like almost $2,000. It's just too expensive for what it is. But I think the iPad is also a good option too. One issue with the iPad, the MacBook, and even these Microsoft Copilot Plus PCs, they're not really good at gaming. So if you do plan on gaming, I would recommend getting a gaming laptop. And my recommendation of choice for travel is the new ROG G14 2024, or if you want a bigger screen, the G16. You're not going to get the same amount of FPS as you would with like a dedicated like Razer Blade 16 or Scar 16 or any of those gigantic 18-inch laptops, but it is playable with just about every single game at its native resolution with the RTX 4070 and up. Because they're so thin and relatively light for the type of device it is, I really, really recommend them. They're not as great as the Copilot PCs in terms of battery life and just in terms of being a light device to travel with, but they are really good. But if you don't want to take a gaming laptop and you want to deal with the handhelds, then the Steam Deck OLED is still the best choice. And I did a video on this saying that I got rid of all my other handhelds and this is the only one that I have, and that is true. And there's a lot of reasons for it. What I realized that this performs pretty much identical to the ROG Ally. Let me explain. The ROG Ally has a 1080p screen. This essentially has a 720p screen. But when running at the native resolutions, you end up getting very similar FPS, and OLED just looks tremendously better. You can play this in HDR, and as much as I love Windows, I don't know how I feel about it on handhelds. With a handheld, I just want to press one button and get right into gaming. And just another reason is the convenience. One thing I like about a dedicated handheld system like the Steam Deck is it is made pretty much only for gaming. I launched this game probably 2 to 3 days ago, and all you do is just press the power button and you're right back in, press the power button, it goes into a sleep mode, and then you can just resume right where you left off, kind of just like picking up a book. You can continue right from the page you left off at. Windows doesn't have a great standby system for gaming. A lot of times the battery either dies or the game gets frozen while it's in its sleep state, and having to go through Windows first to get to a game launcher is kind of inconvenient for the purpose of what I want a handheld for. It's just really nice to have this home screen where all of your games are immediately accessible to you. And I know both the ROG Ally and the Legion Go have dedicated apps to make this easier, but it's still running through Windows. This is just, for me, just a lot better of an experience. But again, OLED screen and HDR makes this better than a 1080p IPS screen, in my opinion. So now that you got that covered, let's talk about my favorite audio right now, which I used to use the Bose 700s. And so I did a video on this Sonos Ace, and I was a little bit mixed about it at first, but after having it for about a month now, I think I'm past the return period and I can't return this anymore. I was a little bit iffy on the sound quality. I felt like it sounded a bit artificial. I don't know if my ears adapted to it or there's been a firmware update, and there has been, and things just sound a lot more natural to me. And especially since now that I switched back to Android and I'm able to make use of aptX, and aptX Adaptive works really well on the Sonos Ace. I've used it a lot on many different devices, and there's always been like some weird cutouts or the audio quality would take a dip when using aptX Adaptive. So that's why I never really cared about that platform, but it just seems to work a lot better on the Sonos Ace. These have excellent noise cancellation, the best transparency that's not an Apple product like an AirPod, and overall, really comfortable, and I really like these. But I did say in my video, if you have like a Sony XM4s, 5s, or the Bose 700s, I don't think this really is warranted an upgrade. I think these type of headphones are kind of like at the peak of the performance. So like now every year, we're only getting like iterative updates. So if these are too big for you and you want in-ears, my favorite is still the Sony XM5s, the earbuds. These support LDAC and they work really good on Android phones. They do sound good on iPhones. But if you do have an iPhone, I would still recommend the AirPods. It just works really well on Apple products. And in terms of the whole integration, The noise cancellation is very good on these AirPod Pros too. On the Android side, if you want something equivalent, by far my favorite, and also cheaper than the XM5s, are these Nothing Ears. This is the new one for 2024. They had a Nothing Ear 1, a 2. Now they're just called the Nothing Ears. And these sound great. Transparency is okay. Not as good as the Sonos Ace, and definitely not as good as the AirPod series. But noise cancellation is adequate, good enough for airplane and train travel, I would say. And this is my recommendation as a bit of a lower cost alternative to the XM5s. So I'm not going to try to compare it to those, but in terms of audio quality, it's almost there. And especially with Bluetooth LE, if your phone supports that, iPhone users, nope, you're out of luck. You're only getting AAC. Also, man, the design on this is incredible. But Bluetooth is laggy and you have to depend on batteries. If you want a great headphone and you still have a device that supports a headphone jack, this is by a company called Antline, and they sent this out to me for review. No money exchange hands or anything, but these are by far the best sounding headphones I've ever heard, whether they're over ear or on ears or in ears for $150. In fact, they rival some of my $350 to $400 headphones. All right, guys, and I just want to give you an idea of how the microphone sounds. By far the best microphone that I own that isn't like this gigantic thing right here, but I've been using this for all my work meetings, and because it's wired, you're not dealing with a connection or a dongle or anything like that. You just plug it in and it just works. These have two drivers in it, a balanced armature driver and a dynamic driver. Dynamic drivers are typically the speakers you're used to seeing, but balanced armatures are a different type of driver, a different type of technology. You don't really see them that much anymore, but balanced armatures are typically better when it comes to mids and the highs, like hi-hats or if you're playing a game like gunshots, etc., while regular dynamic drivers are better for bass and the lower mids. Having both, you get the best of both worlds. These are much smaller than those gigantic gaming headsets that most of us carry around, but like I said, these are by far some of the best headphones I've ever heard. Okay, so next, cameras. And obviously, you're going to want to take some pictures and create some memories with you while you're on a trip. And I used to carry around my gigantic cameras, my mirrorless cameras with my interchangeable lenses, etc., and all that stuff. But what I was found on those trips is I never really enjoyed the moment. I would look back in the pictures and I would remember being there physically, but I won't remember experiencing it because I was spending too much time with my camera, making sure my exposure's right, etc. Or if I'm like recording on my phone or taking pictures on my phone, I just remember looking through the screen on my phone instead of actually looking at real life. The kind of cameras I'm going to start traveling with now are the ones that just disappear. So there's two I want to talk about. First, this is the Insta360 Go 3S. It's got a flip-out screen, shoots in 4K, but here's a little party trick. This camera itself is removable. Then you end up with a wireless viewfinder here. But because this camera is so small, you can just get some cool angles and stuff that you probably won't be able to get normally. But even better, coming back to that whole rant I did about living in the moment, is that this camera has a magnet on it. So here's a little pendant that it comes with. It's like a, think of it as kind of like a necklace. So you just attach the camera to it and you can put this under your shirt if you wanted to. And you just put this on and then you have a camera and it's got some really good stabilization. So even if you're moving around, it'll maintain it. There's also a free form video mode where it'll completely lock the horizons. It also comes with this clip here. And then this can be connected to a hat. So you can just walk around and just record stuff here. The cool thing about that, like I mentioned, is you can get some cool footage and not ever have to deal with a camera. And this particular Go 3S has a feature where it'll automatically turn on and start recording every few minutes. And then it uses AI to stitch a video together. So it could just create a memory for you without you having to do any work. So you could just focus on enjoying your vacation and not have to worry about editing a video or even taking out your camera. If this is a little bit too complicated for you, my next recommendation would be the Ray-Ban Metas. I also did a video on those and those were incredible. They're just essentially sunglasses. And with the press of a button, it'll record video. Vertical only though, but you don't have to pull out your phone. You're already wearing glasses or sunglasses, so you're able to live the moment while also capture memories. So those are my two recommendations when it comes to that. So the issue with these though is because they are smaller sensors, both the Ray-Ban Meta and this Insta360, it works incredibly good in daylight or when there's a lot of light, but in low light, it does suffer a little bit. I still found the footage to be fairly usable, though, especially if you're just going to be looking at this on your phone. I definitely recommend these. You'll get to both enjoy your vacation and capture memories. Okay, so next I want to talk about these cables, and I've been using them for a while, and I got a lot of questions about them. And I use these every single day to charge my phone, my camera equipment, etc. And it has shown no sign of wear and tear. And what I like about it is, like, at the end of the day, wires are inevitable. We're not in the stage of tech where everything can be wireless. With wireless, you introduce latency, there's less bandwidth. Since cables are necessary, they might as well look good. And these are the best looking cables I've ever used. The cable itself is a really high quality braided pattern. And like I said, I use this every single day. I travel with it. It also comes with a travel case. It has shown no wear and tear at all. All of the connection points are made out of a really high quality aluminum. Great. So this is a 240 watt USB cable. Nothing supports 240 watts, but it'll work perfectly with this 140 watt charger. In most cases, this 65 watt charger will be appropriate for you. And the cool thing about this is it's really slim. It is meant for travel. The actual port itself opens up. And depending on the wall outlet, you can rotate this to fit in any situation. So really clever device. But this is the product that they sent me most recently from Aoi. Again, really good build quality, good feeling rubber on this cable. And again, it's made out of all metal. One interesting thing about this cable, even though it is shorter, this is essentially a USB 4 cable. It's capable of charging at 240 watts as well, but it supports speeds of up to 40 gigabits per second. And it also has DisplayPort built in that could support up to 8K. So if you bring a gaming laptop with you, since this has DisplayPort built in, if you connect this to a compatible monitor, you're able to get G-Sync on this cable. And like I said, it's a really nice looking cable. So yeah, Aoi sent this out to me. They gave me some links for you guys to use. You get 15% off. I don't benefit if you use those links or not. They sent me this product for free just to talk about it. I've been using their stuff for so long. I love the way it looks. I love that it lasts a long time. And yeah, I'm just happy to talk about it. The last thing I want to talk about might be a little bit boring, but it's a battery pack. What I like the most about this particular battery pack, and this is from a company called CookTech, is they don't just make a battery pack and then all of a sudden they're going to make a phone case and then Bluetooth speakers, etc. No, they only make batteries and chargers. That's what all of their R&D goes into. They are a battery manufacturer. This supports 100 watts of fast charging. So if you're using something like the ROG Ally, you won't lose any performance while you're charging this. And this supports 2 full charges on something like the ROG Ally. Really impressive. 2.5 charges on the Steam Deck, and you can charge most laptops to maybe 65%. But yeah, I think that's gonna do it. And the cool thing is, everything fits in that backpack that I featured first. So I hope you guys have a good summer and enjoy your trip wherever you go.